Hello, everybody, and welcome to today's Dynamics 365 Tech Talk. Today's topic is, what's new in the April 2020 release for configurable business documents? My name is Peggy, and I'll be your moderator today. We're broadcasting this web conference through Teams live events, and the audio can be heard through your device speakers. Today's web conference is being recorded on behalf of the Microsoft Corporation. By participating in the session using Microsoft Teams, your name, email address, phone number, and/or title may be viewable by other session participants. If you do not consent to being a part of a recorded session, please disconnect at this time. The recording will be available on the Tech Talks Community Dynamics page within 5 days post-conference. If you have questions to the presenters or need support, please use the Q&A panel located on the right side of your screen. Our presenters will be responding to your questions during today's presentation. We'll have time at the end for any further questions. Thank you for your patience during these announcements. Now on to the presentation. Presenting for us today from Microsoft, we have Mikhail Filatov, Principal Engineering Lead, and Nicola Salin, Senior Program Manager. Welcome, Mikhail. You now have the floor.
Thank you, Peggy. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, everybody. Yeah, my name is Mikhail Filatov. And let's start with the overview of configurable business documents. And then I will go to the main features we are releasing in April 2020 release. We also would talk about different document options and what business documents are available out of the box from Microsoft. And after that, we'll switch to a lot of demos. We'll do 4 demos for you. And we'll have quite a lot of time for Q&A at the end. But yes, Peggy said you can ask all the questions in the panel as we go. This slide is an overview of architecture of configurable business documents. And what is important is to see 2 personas, Phyllis and Simon. And Phyllis, she's an accounting manager, and her role is actually to manage AR, EP, and she knows Office pretty well, but does not know any technical details about ERP, right? So business document management workspace, we have created specially for a business user like Phyllis, where she can edit in Office Online or in Office Desktop her business documents like invoices, quotations, and etc. But all this functionality is actually based on electronic reporting functionality, which provides versioning, publishing functionality, and also allows you to configure destinations. And we'll talk a lot about them because this destination gives you a possibility to convert your Office document to a PDF, for example, and then send it as an attachment over mail or paint it or just see it on the screen. And after you've done with your publishing, you can put all these configurations to what we call global repo, is our storage for configuration versions. And also we support LCS. But we will talk why we recommend you to consider global repo, because we provides quite a lot of good new functionality there, which makes working with configuration easier in general and specifically with business documents. And this electronic reporting functionality is oriented towards Simon. And Simon, he is a functional consultant, so he is not a developer, but he is quite technical, right? So he knows a lot about ERP functional model, about ERP data model, right? But he is also not a developer. So all those tools are no code tools, but we targeted to 2 different personas. One is Phyllis, who is a business user, and another is Simon, who is a functional consultant. So he's more like a power user. Then let's go to the overview of a new functionality for configurable business documents. Because if you remember, we released business documents in October 2019 release, but now in April 2020, we are providing quite a lot of additional features. So our first feature we will show to you is new user interface. And the idea of the new user interface is that you see in the workspace for business documents only your documents. You don't see all the templates. It's similar to what Excel, for example, provides. And then you click a new document button and you see the list of available templates. Also, you can get this new template from Global Repper, and we'll talk about it as well. Then the most requested feature, which we release as a public preview in April release, is conversion to PDF. It allows you on the fly to convert Excel or Word document, which you configure in business documents, to be saved as PDF and sent to email or just shown as a file on screen. And based on this conversion to PDF, we now also are releasing direct printing support in public preview. It allows you to configure your printers, which you set up in DRA, document routing agent, and print them directly without going to Excel or Word document. And the last, but not the list of these features are enhanced filtering options for finding configurations in the global repository. This feature allows you to quickly filter a required configuration, and in case of business document, just search, for example, for all sales confirmations which you have read and import only them. So it simplifies the process of getting a required business document in your environment. Now, all this functionality which we have released before allows you to do a quick customization of available templates. But the last feature we'll be talking about today, template upload for using existing layouts of business documents, allows you to import a brand new template, for example, of invoice or packing slip, etc., right? Which let's say your vendor sent to you, right, in Excel format, and then you can just take it and import it to the system and start working with this template, right? So it simplifies the customization story for you, so you can start from an already existing template. And just to remind you that again, business documents is just one of the options we have for documents, reporting and analytics in Dynamics 365 for finance and supply chain management. And if specifically we compare with SSRS, I would say that the main target for SSRS is developer experience. And if you do a lot of precision formats and especially label painting, that's probably where you should use SSRS. And business documents, they're no code business user or power user experience based on Office 365 and electronic reporting. So both options are available, and to answer the questions which I'm getting quite often, we support both SSRS and configurable business documents for the same set of business documents like invoice, packing slip, etc. And as of now, there are no plans to, say, deprecate SSRS, so both options are supported. So it's up to you, depending on your situation, what you need to paint, right, etc. So you can use either SSRS or configurable business documents. And here's the list of all available templates. And basically, we have completed the uptake of all the documents which are supported via print management in the system across all the modules, SAP, EP, ER, project, warehouse, etc. So all of them are available, right, and can be downloaded either from LCS or from Global Repository. Okay, that's all for slides. So now let's switch to demos. Now I am in business document management workspace. And as I mentioned to you before, right, I see only my templates, which were created by myself or other members of my team in my environment. So how can I create a new document? Let's say I'm a Phyllis and I need to do a customization of Phyllis invoice. I press new document button and here in create a new template, I see a list of all available templates in the system, which was taken from Global Repository. So I can choose any of them, what I need, free text invoice. Say create document, I call it free text invoice Excel TikTok. And the system creates this new document and open it in Office Online UX. Right, and also if needed, right, you can open a desktop application to edit it in Excel desktop. So I can do whatever I want here, right? Change some colors. I can insert a picture, for example. But I can do much, much more, right? And for example, if I need to extend the fields which we see in the templates, I can do it here as well. If you look at the company address, we see that I have phone, fax, email, etc., but there is no company website, right? So how I can edit? I just say, let's add a new row. And so and yeah, and then I can add additional field via this column on the right panel on the right hand side, and the system highlight me, you see in blue, to which cell in Excel actually I am adding this range. I'm doing it now. And after the range is added to the structure of the document, I can actually do the mapping of this range to my data model. And we use what we call a data model. It's a system independent model, which is based on OUBL standard, which we actually use both for electronic reporting and for business document. And we have quite a lot of information here. So here's the company information. And I can find this website and actually bind it. So you see that this web URL node is actually binded to the website now. Okay, I'm done with my changes. I'm saving them. And after that, immediately I can go ahead and actually use this a new document in my system. I'm going to the list of all free text invoices. I'm going to paint management. And here I need to choose my new document. Here it is. And now I can paint it. And again, the system will show me now this Excel document, but again, we'll do it to you several demos to see how we can actually do the customization in and convert it to a PDF. So you see, website is here and picture is here. So now a small change which we did is how you can get the new documents into the system. For this one, you need to use Global Library, as I mentioned, and you need to go to electronic reporting repositories and open Global Configuration Repository. And actually, it contains the list of all documents, right, in the system. But you can filter them by either functional area or, in our case, for business documents, but business document type. So here, like the list of all the tags for business documents, right, which we have in the system. So I already have a few of them, so I can choose, for example, this one, Sales Invoice Excel, and just say import, and the system will import the specific document for me, so it would not import all the remaining configurations, only the one which I needed for me. Okay, so let's now do other demos, and I would ask Nikolai Selin to take over the mic and do say other demos.
Thank you, Mikhail. Let me share my desktop. Is that visible?
Yes.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Let me continue our presentation. So the first demo will be dedicated to the new functionality that can allow you to convert the documents that you can generate by using the electronic reporting framework in Office formats, Excel and Word, to PDF format. So as an example, I will use one of the jar configurations containing templates in Excel format that you can manage and modify by using the configurable business document feature. And I've configured for this solution the screen destination. And if I would configure my print management settings to start using this solution for generation of free text and voices, I expect to get this generated document previewed on the screen in Excel format. And here you can see this generated document, and as you can see, the Office Online Viewer is used to preview this document because it's generated in Excel format. Because for generation this document, we used the Excel-based template. So sometimes you would prefer to get this document as a PDF document. And starting from the Finance version 10.09, JAR supports this capability. First, what you need to do, you need to go to the Feature Management workspace and enable the appropriate feature of the organization administration module. And when you did that, and when you come back to the JAR destinations, you will see one more option that you can use for every record specifying your destination. And in our case, you can say that I would like to convert the generated free text and voice from Excel format to PDF. So now if I would repeat the generation of my document, I will expect that it will be now available to me as PDF document. So as you can see, it's not Excel anymore, it's a PDF. So for generation of such PDF files, we use the same technique as the Power Automate use. So the conversion is performed in a special service. So that's why you can use for Excel the only fonts that are available in the standard Windows installation. So currently you can't bring into Excel some special fonts to generate, for example, barcodes. We think of this functionality, but it's a limitation for now for Excel outputs. For Word outputs, you can use the embedded fonts. And in this case, in Word documents, you can get your barcodes either as in Word documents or in the converted PDF files. So just to show to you that the PDF conversion supported not only for screen preview, but for any other supported destination, I will enable my email destination that I've configured in advance to get information about the email recipient from my data model. It will be email of my customer contact, and to generate subject and body text, I will use the data sources from my format, which is configured to reuse organization email template that I've configured in advance as well. So I will be using this template. And I expect to get my email with the attached document in this mailbox. So that's our screen preview destination. And here we expect to have our email. So here it is. And as you can see, this document now is a PDF one. So now you are able to attach your documents in PDF format. And also just a small comment that sometimes you probably would need to have at the same time the document which is converted to PDF, but at the same time you would need to store the original document, for example, to archive it or for any other reason. So in this case it's also possible. What you need to do is just to configure two different destinations for the same format elements producing your actual document. And if you did that, if you generate your document using the JR destination configured in this way, you will have two new tabs in your browser. When in one you will see the document in Excel format in our case, and in another one it will be the PDF document. So as you can see, it's an Excel and here it's a PDF. So this functionality is supported as well. The second feature I would like to show to you is the possibility to print out such documents directly from the electronic reporting at the time when you generated this document. This printing is based on the PDF conversion, and start doing this, you need to prepare your finance application for supporting direct printing. You need to download the document routing agent installation package. After that, you need to install it locally. I did it on my virtual machine. Configure it to use it from your finance application. You need to configure your local printer. Register this printer in your document routing agent. I've also configured this local printer to store every incoming documents to this local folder. And when you did that, you can come back, refresh this page and activate this printer for your current company. So now your finance application is ready to support direct printing, and you need to enable for that the electronic reporting framework. So what you need to do in this case, you need to go again to the feature management and enable the integration between the document routing agent and electronic reporting framework feature. For enabling it, first you need to enable the PDF conversion because it's a base for our direct printing. Since we enabled this feature earlier, we can just enable the document routing agent integration feature. So now if we go back to our electronic reporting destinations, we'll see that I can just delete this one, so we don't need it. That in addition to the earlier supported destination, we have one more destination printer. And if you enable it, you will see the list of printers that you've configured. And you can select the desired one. And also, if you want to archive your files that you will send to the printer, you can select this option as well. Just one more comment, you can keep this flag turned on or turned off. It doesn't really matter, even if it will be off. Since you've selected the printer destination, the PDF conversion for printing will be performed automatically anyway. So we will save it. We'll go to our list of invoices. And process the selected document. So that's the result of execution of our screen destination. Go to our DRA, we'll see that the DRA processed our document. And as we've configured, we expect that this file will be stored locally. So that's our document. And if we go to our print archive, you'll see that here we have a just generated document. And if you go to the document routing agent log, you will see that it will contain the document we've just processed. So here it is. So that's how you can support the direct printing of the documents generated by the electronic reporting framework. And the third feature I would like to show to you is the feature allowing you to bring to your finance application a new template for your business documents by using the configurable business document feature when you've prepared this template outside of the system. As Mikhail already shown to you, when you go to the business document management, and if you want to create a new template, you have a possibility to select as a base one of the already available in the system templates. But sometimes probably you would need to use the externally prepared template. For example, what you can do, you can just open the library of the templates that is available in the Microsoft Office and select, for example, this template to use it for your customer invoices. Or you can pick up a document provided by the customer and start using it as a template to produce invoices for this particular customer. So for doing that, instead of the option select from the existing list, you can click the option upload. And here you can just pick up the externally prepared template. And after that, you need to specify for what kind of documents you would like to use this template. And we'll say, okay, we would like to generate free text invoices for using this new template. After that, there is a question, which data source will be used to fill in this template at runtime? And as a data source, the jar configuration containing the data model component will be used. And actually, it's a data model that Simon imported from, for example, LCS shared asset library in advance for Phyllis. And you can automatically find the most appropriate or the most relevant data model using this filtering option when all the information you've entered earlier will be used to find the most relevant data model. In our case, the invoice model has been selected as the most relevant one. And since this model is designed to produce different kind of invoices, we need to specify what subset of this data model will be used for this particular template and select the invoice customer root definition. So when we completed this, all these steps, this template becomes available in the configurable business document editor. You can just refine it in here. And also what you can do, you can bind the Excel names as the fields of this template with the appropriate fields of the data model you've selected as a data source for your template. For example, I would like to say, okay, I would like to fill in this company name Excel field by using a certain data source field. I'll say, okay, in the model, I will find the invoice base. Here I will find the subset of the company info, and in the company info, I will find the name field. Okay, I will say bind. I will save my changes. And just to see how this document will look like if I would start using it to produce my free text invoices, I will just select the template we've just created and start using it for processing the selected invoice. Since I have not configured any destinations, by default, it will be offered to me as a downloaded file. And here we can see that we have the free text invoice form generated by using the template we have just created, using the externally prepared file, and based on our binding, the company name field has been filled in by the company name of the company which is processing this invoice. So that's it about those new features. So now I guess it's time for Mikhail to bring back his desktop, his deck, and share it.
Do you see my screen, guys?
Yes.
Yes, I do.
Okay, so we'll go to questions shortly, but before that, just to end our deck, right? So the main node I saw center for configurable business documents is this one. It's aka.ms business document management. And we will publish all the new features, updates within this landing page. And also we have quite a lot of information about electronic reporting functionality, right? We did not demo it today, but actually the tech talk available on electronic reporting, right? And quite a lot of documentation and training, right? So, and again, if you have any specific questions, feel free to send a mail to me and Nikolai, and we will follow up with you, right? So your success is our success, right? And we want to make business document a very successful product. Okay, thank you everybody, right? And with this said, let's switch to questions. We have quite a lot of questions, right? So we can actually start, because I think we answered some of them in the chat, right? But we can start probably the one which is not answered with how can we modify the data model, include batch attributes to pick and sleep? Maybe Nikolai, if you can start answering this.
So what you need to do, you need just to extend the existing data model. You need to take the existing one, create a derived version of it, and in this data model you need to put the extension of the existing data model, just configuring the necessary levels and fields. After that you need to derive the existing model mapping referring to your custom data model, and in this case your new elements of the data model will appear in the model mapping designer, where you can just specify the actual sources of data to fill in those new fields of your data model. So after that, when you completed your data model and model mapping, you can create the derived version of our GR format containing such a template that I've shown. And since it will use your modified model, all new fields will be available in the format designer, and you can specify to which place of your modified format you would like to put information from those custom fields of your custom data model.
Yeah, thank you. Next one, is it possible to quote logic? For instance, the charges description and charge value is printed on the invoice. For instance, freight 100 USD is printed since the charge of the sales order in D65. Yes, it's possible. Again, we have a formula designer, right, in electronic reporting, right? So you can have a look at any of our documents, like say free text invoice, which we demoed here, right? It has quite a lot of logic conditions, right? Example for different countries, right, and different scenarios to show some section or don't show some section. How to add product images to invoice quotations? Is this supported?
Yes, it's supported. There is a special data type in the GR data model container. So what you need to do, you need just, if you are talking about some custom images, not about the standard logo or something similar, again, as I've described, you can just modify the existing data model and bring in a new field with a data type container. And in the model mapping, you need to bind it with the source of your image. For example, it can be either the blob field in your database table, or it can be, for example, an attachment where you keep your image as a, you know, this picture file. So at runtime, it will be converted to the container. And when you will read this container from data model, you can place the content of this container to the placeholder that you've placed to your template. It can be just a blank picture. And at runtime, it will be filled in by the actual picture taken from your data source.
Okay, next one. Is it possible to add general terms and conditions as a sub-document to Excel Word? I say that like sub-documents are not supported now, right? But you can actually generate several documents at one time, right? So we support actually in electronic reporting, right? What we call folder, right? So you can generate several documents if needed, or you can just add for this general terms and condition as a section, right, in your document, and maybe depending on the some conditions show or not show it, right? Or as I said, like you can generate several documents at once for a configuration, right? So this is supported.
Alternatively, if you're talking about the Excel output, what you can do, if you're talking about some text which should not be changed at runtime, you can just put it to a new worksheet. So in this case, you will have one outbound document, one workbook containing different multiple worksheets, and one of them will contain something like a general terms and conditions. And if you will configure the PDF converted destination, you will have one PDF where you will have multiple pages, because when the Excel is converted to PDF, every worksheet from the generated Excel will be converted.
Right. Can as invoice number be embedded into PDF file name?
Yes, and actually in this example, you will see that for the pro forma invoice, instead of the ID, you will see the rec ID, like a temporary ID. Yes.
Yes. So let's go to the next question. Let me see. I think that what we have here. Can you create your own documents and add them to the system with only one set of the system? I think we showed this, right? So basically you can upload a new template, right? And I think that from the, let's say, it depends, right? If it's just your version of free text invoice, yes, you can add it, right? But if you think about completely new documents, right, there are two things here, right? You can add any specific configuration, right, which doesn't exist in the system, it's no problem, right, and we support it, like, but print management has a defined list of document types, right? So basically, in order for you to create a new document which would appear in like paint management, right, so you can choose AR configurations, you need to customize paint management as well and add it as an enum, right? And then you can actually use this enum and define the business document tag, right, for this. So I think in general, yes, you can create any configuration, it's not related to system limitations, but if you want to link it to paint management, right, then you should define what type of document from paint management type, right, it is, right, and if it doesn't exist, you need to customize and extend it. Are the data sources used by templates based on data entities or something else? You can use actually almost anything from the system, right? So we support data entities, tables, classes, and especially for
objects, enums, number sequences, everything.
Everything. And I think if you talk specifically about business documents, right, what we did, we provide the mapping for RDP classes, right? So, because the idea is that like a lot of you have customized these RDP classes, right? So we want to preserve this investment. And basically, if you have customizations, when you add additional fields in RDP, right, so like additional methods, you would be able to use them in your model mappings, right? So they would just appear immediately, right? So it would be much easier for you to map these additional fields, right? But from the tool perspective, right, in general, as Nikolai mentioned, we support almost everything, right, from finance and supply chain management. Can you add these new fields to the documents? I think I think we demoed it, right? So yeah, basically, yes, you can add new fields to the document. Is PDF conversion also works on premise environment?
No, it does not work on premise environments because in on-premise all the generated documents can be stored locally and all of them under your control. So you can use any conversion tools you want and you don't need us for doing that. For now, it's not supported for on-premises.
Yeah, so we use a standard Microsoft conversion tool, which is used by other services like Power Automate, etc. Right? So, is there an example in Word format?
We have an example of free text and voices. You can find some previously recorded tech talks, and you can see that you can, like I've shown today, by using Excel templates library, you can pick up the Word template from the Office library and start using it as a new template. And there are some videos how it can be done.
Yes, and check out the previous TikTok which we did in October, right? So it has the demo of using Word. And again, we have plans to extend our support of templates and add some Word templates, right? So this plan is being finalized now, right? It should be available soon, right? But again, from like tutorial perspective, yes, there are examples how you can do it. Can bulk email sending invoices to multiple customers in PDF supported, be supported?
You can run it on batch. Yes, in this case, it will be performed as a massive.
Yeah, I think it should work. And yeah, it worked in batch as well. Can you set fields to only show on the first page? Common request, so more lines can be shown on page 2+.
Yes, actually, there are two ways for doing paging, and actually, JR supports two of them. The first one, when you configure your document, when you rely on the paging provided by Excel. In this case, what you can do, just say, okay, I would like to format your like a number of pages, title and the header on the footer in a certain font and something like this. And after that, everything which is related to paging will be performed by Excel. Alternatively, if you want to do paging by yourself, you need to use the built-in JR functions to produce certain batches of lines to be printed out on every page. And in this case, you can use all the power of the JR designer to specify what should be shown or hidden on the first or on the last page, something like that. So it depends which way you will choose.
Okay, what versions of MS Office are supported?
It's mentioned somewhere in the documentation, starting from the 2016, as far as I remember.
Yeah, I think we have, if you go to this aka.ms business document management, right, we have actually a section dedicated to supported versions. So please check it out. How do you add new data to the data model? I think we already discussed it, right? So you need to customize our data model, right, derive from it, add new fields, and then also do a like model mapping, right? So map it to your data in the system, right? And then in your template, this field would appear, right? So that you can use them.
Just a small comment, as Michael already mentioned at the beginning of the presentation, so everything that he described, it can be done by Simon with no coding approach, so it will be fully configurable. Just the power user can do this, bind it with the appropriate data sources and immediately start using it. So there will be no downtime, no necessity to install any packages or something like that. So it's fully configurable.
All right. Is subtotaling and transport amount supported?
So I would not answer. I can't answer. It's very specific. So it's better to contact to the owners of the GR solutions providing these particular reports.
Yeah, but I think in general, yes, we support totals, right? But again, if you have a special scenario, we can discuss it, right? But yes,
for totals, yeah, for totals, you can calculate totals by using the built-in functions, and there are different ways for doing that. One of them, when you can do it based on the source of data, for example, you can create a data source that will directly call the SQL database and perform the group by and aggregation calculation on the server. But sometimes from the performance improvement perspective, you can even do this summing and counting on the fly when you can use as a data source the information you've already populated to the generated document. So it will be much faster and it will guarantee that actually you are counting and summing the values which you already really populated to the document. So yes, it's supported.
Okay, so isn't it possible to select a destination when running an airport document, like getting a printer dialog to select which destination should get used?
It's possible. Yes, I forgot to show it to you, but there is a special privilege, and if this privilege is granted to the end user, when you will initiate the process, there will be one more pop-up dialog, like you can see when you use, for example, the SSRS report. And if it's a GR report, on this report you will see the lookup presenting all the configured by default destinations, and there will be the button change. So when you select it, you will see all the destinations, including printer. And when you select printer, you will be able to select one of the printers configured in advance. Yes, it's possible. Just a matter of the security settings for the end user.
Yes. Can you join in NEST tables to get to other fields and information? For example, on TMS commercial invoice, can you link to production orders? Yes, you know, it's like basic functionality of electronic reporting, right? So you can go through the list of relations, right? And add each any related tables, right? So it's fully supported in general, right? And you can look at our configurations, right? To see how it actually works, yeah. Right?
Yeah. Yes, and you can go even further, because sometimes you would need to join some tables when there are no relations between them. Sometimes it happens, and GR supports the join data source, where you can specify a pair of fields you would like to use to do this join. And you can just configure such a data source, and you can access the related tables even when physically the relation is not available in AOT. Yes, it's possible.
Okay, so we have a couple more questions. Is there any support to store generated documents to Azure Blob Storage?
Yes, there is a destination archive. If you selected this destination, all the documents, successfully generated documents, they will be stored as a Azure Blob files as a document management attachments of the record in the GR execution log. So for every execution, you will have a log record, and all the generated documents will be attached to it. And physically, they will be stored in the Azure Blob storage. If you configure it, your document type for doing that, having the Azure storage provider. But alternatively, you can select other supported storage providers, for example, SharePoint.
Yes. How is pagination handled? For example, I need to print specific text at the end of document. My document contains 8 pages, and I only want the text to print on the last page.
Yeah, we already discussed that, so it depends on the paging, and you can do it in both ways. Either specifying the special footer for the last page, if paging is performed in Excel, or just using this enabling feature in GR when you can specify that particular text should be hidden until you generate the last page.
Okay, can you create your own data models on data entities? Yes, again, you can create your own data models, right? So we are, from the tool perspective, we are not limiting like to our data models, while we encourage you to use our data models because we try to make them as, let's say, well-defined, right? And support broader range of scenarios, right? You can create your own data models, and yes, you can map them to data entities, tables, whatever, it's up to you, right? So if you want to go, let's say, with, for example, some vertical, right, and define a data model which we don't support, yes, you can do it and map it to data entities. Is it possible to force page breaks in the output similar to what we would do in SSRS, for instance, after a certain number of cell slides?
Yes, there is a special format element page break. So if you will add it to your JAR format designed to produce Excel documents, yes, it will be just like a page break force. Yes.
Okay, so we have several more. Is it possible to have the free text invoice paint in the customer language?
Yes, there is a special field in the file format element, which language should be used to produce this document. And there are four options available for this attribute. One, you can specify the predefined, like a hard-coded language. The second, you can use the language configured for the user running this format. Usually this option is used for control reports, just to generate for the end user the document in his preferred language. The third one, that's when you can pick up the language from the company. It's mostly when the company specifies which language should be used for this particular report, usually from the legal perspective. And the fourth one, yes, you can specify the language at runtime, and you can configure it by an expression where you can say, okay, for generation this document, I would like to use the language which is defined for the current customer, for example.
Okay, and I think we have time for several more. Yeah, is it possible to add notes in the bottom of the reports? Yes, yes, it's possible, right? I was playing around with AR framework and I wanted to use public constants in if statements and found out that I can only use methods or fields or enums. Do you have any plans to support also constants in expressions?
It depends what kind of constants, because you can, if you, for example, you would like to use a particular constant around the format you are designing, you can just introduce this constant as a calculated field, and you can configure multiple expressions, and in every expression you can refer to this calculated field. So from the like a design perspective, it will be something like a public variable available for your format. You can do the same in the data model, in the model mapping, and in this case, it will be like a public variable for every format you designed under this model.
Okay, and I think we have time for maybe one more. What about an external Azure Blob storage? I would like to use server events.
It's not clear for what kind of events.
Yeah, I think that we actually what we do, and I think we have actually a way for you to extend the list of destinations we support, right? For example, right? So there's an extensibility point for this, right? But probably we can follow up with you offline, right? If you can describe us this specific scenario, right? To see what is actually available or not. Okay, I think that we are at the end of the hour, right? Thank you, everybody. And if you have any specific questions, just please ping, send a mail to myself or Nikolai. So now giving the stage back to Peggy.
All right, thank you, Mikhail. Thanks for everybody who joined today. We would love to get your feedback, excuse me, on today's session. So if you could please take a moment to fill out the short survey, I've posted the link to that. And the recording will be available within 5 business days on the Tech Talk community site, which I posted earlier as well. So I'd like to extend a big thank you to our presenters and our audience. Have a great day or evening wherever you are.